That's right. I had to think about, then how do you do this, since it had never been done? And going through my mind were things like, if I appear to be the usurper of power, that won't be, I mean, Tennessee will be even more of a laughing stock than it was because of the pardons. Governor Blanton is the commander-in-chief of a National Guard of 10,000 people. He can surround the Capitol. He's got a whole highway patrol. He can surround the Capitol with that. I knew enough to know that the swearing in of a governor is not the executive's prerogative under the Constitution. It's a legislative ceremony. We'd already had the speakers out to my home to plan it. They didn't much like the idea of having a young Republican governor anyway. And having one just usher himself into office wouldn't go over very, very well.
I hope we will all take away from either the book or this discussion or both is that is this. I mean, I appreciate that a lot of the appeal of the story has to do with the scandal and the corruption and the trouble. And I did feel we had to tell enough of that story for a reader 30-some years later to appreciate it. What was that all about? I mean, what gave rise to that? What was that trouble that's been discussed here tonight, too? But genuinely, what was more interesting to me was how these other folks worked through the solution on that afternoon. There was a crisis, but there was also the solution. And I would just say that this is not so much a story of bad guys doing wrong as it was about good guys doing right. And I think that's worth holding up.